Welcome to The Better Part. Today, we'll be talking with two exciting, dedicated organisations that are doing a great deal to serve and unite their community. One, helping good people become great leaders, and the other, connecting community through media. Shelley Wolfe talks with Alicia Crank of Leadership Mountain View. Plus, I'll find out from Shelley what's new here at KMVT15. Please stay tuned.
Welcome to The Better Part, a program that encompasses a diverse spectrum of topics important to our community, which we hope will both inform and entertain you. We invite you to sit back and enjoy the program.
Thank you very much, Val. I'm here and so grateful to be here today with Alicia Crank, the director for Leadership Mountain View. We're going to be talking about Leadership Mountain View, which is a very crucial leadership program, and I look forward to hearing more from Alicia Crank. So welcome, Alicia. How are you?
Thank you, Shelley. How are you?
I'm great. I am so thrilled to have you here. I know you guys are celebrating 25 years of Leadership Mountain View, and what a great program. Could you give us a quick overview and history of the program to where it started to how it got to where it is today?
Sure. The Leadership Mountain View program is a program of the Chamber of Commerce here in Mountain View, and it started in 1990 with about a class of 7 to 8 people. And it's a civic and community leadership program, so it's for adults, anyone that either lives or works in Mountain View or has some kind of interest in Mountain View. Since then, we're in our 25th year, and we have a class of about 31 people this year, one of our largest classes that we've had in a while, and we have about 550 alumni. So it's a really great program. It's a great way for people to learn about the city of Mountain View, from business to education to health and human services, in a robust 9-month program.
Wow. So you kind of answered my question of why it's relevant to Mountain View, but how can people get involved with the leadership program?
Well, first of all, we have our website, we have our information online, but again, like I said, it's a program of the chamber. Okay. People can go online, they can look at our Facebook page and kind of see a lot of the things that we do. One of the things that I like doing as a director is during our program days, which is one day a month from September to May, I like to kind of live post and let people see some of the things that we're doing. So once they look at what the program's about, look at the video that was produced by KMVT, which is really awesome, and ask questions, I will sit down with that person and kind of figure out if it's, you know, the right thing for them to do.
Great. Well, why don't you walk us through actually like a basic day of what a day would look like being in Leadership Mountain
View? There's no basic day. They each are a little different, but I'll try to just talk about two of them.
Okay.
One is the very first day, which is a big team building day. And on that day, we meet all day at Microsoft here in Mountain View, their Silicon Valley campus. And we spend the day getting to learn about each other. I think one of the crucial things about the leadership program is really implementing interpersonal leadership, meaning about connecting with each other and not looking at your cell phone every 5 minutes, you know, while you're trying to hold a conversation. It's about, you know, looking at each other like we are and just really having an engaging conversation. And at the end of that day, Microsoft actually hosts a really nice kind of welcome reception where program alumni from other years can come and meet the new class. Mm-hmm. So it's a great networking opportunity. And then you have a day like our Health and Human Services Day, which is what we had in December. We're at El Camino Hospital, and we do a lot of what I call field tripping. We do a tour of the hospital. We get to see areas that's not open to the general public. We tour the RotaCare Clinic, which is a free clinic here in Mountain View that not a lot of people know about, which is really not a good thing. But it's one of the things that people walk away with saying, I learned something new. And then in the afternoon, program members can choose one of a handful of safety net services in the community to go and visit and meet with the executive directors and their staff. Usually community services agency, CHAC, the day worker center, the senior center. Right. So no typical one day, but each day really does give you an opportunity to see a lot in a little bit of time.
That's fantastic. And I think that the great part about that program is, like you said, you're exploiting them to other organizations that they may not have known about in the community and really connecting them. Is there a volunteer aspect involved with all of that?
Absolutely.
As well?
I know that a lot of our alumni come back to volunteer, whether it's on my advisory council, and that's made up of about a dozen people that help me to execute the program days. And then there's opportunities throughout the year if we have events in the community, whether it's our graduation that we have at the end of the program year, to volunteering at the Art and Wine Festival. We are the only ones at the festival that have the non-alcoholic booth. So we sell the water and the soda, which is a great opportunity for middle and high school students to come and volunteer, because they usually need some kind of volunteer credit as part of their curriculum. And it's just a great way to kind of be out and be in the sun and offer refreshment.
Absolutely.
And be able to talk about what the program is to other people.
Absolutely. Well, as a past member, I know I got to volunteer doing the fireman's breakfast.
Yes.
And serving the seniors and stuff. So it was a lot of fun.
Absolutely.
And learning about the organizations that exist out there. In terms of getting other community members, do you actually go out and really try to solicit, or do people actually just kind of come to the program? How have you found that to work for the system?
Word of mouth. It's funny, one of the hardest things should be to recruit for the program, but it's actually one of the easiest, because thankfully people are happy with what they got out of the program, and they're already telling their coworkers, their neighbors, their family members that this is the program they should go through to kind of figure out what it is that they want to do in the community. Mm-hmm. The program members range from someone who just moved here, like you had, and getting a crash course in, you know, Mountain View 101, if you will.
Absolutely.
And it can also range to someone that works here in the city, whether it's a city employee, whether it's a small business owner. And then we have people that have lived here for 20 and 30 years who really realize that they don't know as much about what's here in Mountain View than they thought they did.
Right. No, it's a fantastic program. I can't say enough about it. It really enriched my life, I know, and I met a lot of people and really got me connected in Mountain View. So,
and I'll even say in my time, even though this is now my fifth year running the program, I learn something different each and every time,
right,
even though I'm the one that's planning it. And I think by design, I want to make sure that that happens.
Right.
Because I'm there from beginning to end. And I want to know that I'm learning something different, too, each time, even if it's the same subject matter,
right,
year to year.
Well, and I think that's something to express to people, that even though it may be the same subject matter, it's not necessarily the same topical thing. So you have different speakers that come in.
Absolutely.
Through the program, and it's not always the same folks or the same exact topics. And always the class itself draws and creates different conversation,
right,
too, based on who's in the class. So
one of the things I try to make sure to do is that our speakers are people that are decision makers. So it's not the assistant to the assistant to the assistant. Not that there's anything wrong with that person, but you really want to have someone that's in front of everyone that can really answer the tough questions.
Right.
And the tough questions do come out, especially during, you know, things that have to do with healthcare or education or public safety.
Sure.
So when both the police and fire chief come to talk to the class during public safety day, they do get the tough questions, and they're able to get the answers from the people that make those decisions.
Right.
The other part of it is too, is I put some of the program members to work depending on what they do. We have an arts and media day. So when you went through it, obviously, there was no value in having you sit in the audience,
right,
you know, and having someone come and tell you about media.
Right.
And like, you're the media person, show the rest of your classmates what it is that you do and why it's important.
Right.
The same thing with Public Safety Day. We've been blessed to be able to have two officers come through the program every year under Chief Vermeer.
Right.
And they know that day they're working.
Right.
I want them to be able to show what it is that they do and be able to highlight it. And so that's the other way to kind of make sure that there's something new every year.
Right.
And that give people an opportunity in the program to kind of show what it is that they do and why it's important to them.
Fantastic. Well, can you tell us a little bit about what distinguishes Mountain View's program between other communities?
And it's awesome. we are fortunate to be a small city with an international presence. My counterparts in San Jose and Oakland and San Francisco, they're large cities, they have large budgets, they have all these different things going on. And then you have smaller cities, you know, like Santa Cruz and Gilroy, that focus on agriculture, which they absolutely should. Mountain View was an orchard city for a very long time, but it's very fortunate for us that for a city that's 12.2 square miles and 75,000 people, we have Google, Microsoft, Intuit, Synopsys, Symantec, all in our backyard.
Right.
And they want to be a part of the community. So we're able to have, you know, these kind of sought after world class speakers come and talk to our little group every year. Mm-hmm. It's really something that adds to the value of the program.
Absolutely.
And we make sure not to abuse that, but we also make sure to showcase it and say, right. this is a very great thing for us.
Absolutely. And let's also talk that we also do get to bring in some of the political figures as well.
Absolutely.
Within our community.
Absolutely.
So.
Our government day is an expansion of what used to be city day. The first half of the day, we spend with city employees and the city council members. They come and talk outside of the Brown, you know, within the Brown Act, you know what they can discuss about their experience and how they ended up being in elected office. And then in the afternoon, we talk to our county and state elected officials. And again, a lot of them are in our backyard as well.
Right.
When we brought Santa Clara DA Rosen into the as a speaker into our government day about 3.5 years ago, he was a Mountain View resident and had just been elected to be the DA. And I think a lot of people, when they think of county DA, they think San Jose, because that's right. where the main office is. But it was nice to be able to showcase that he's our neighbor,
right?
And it's beyond that. And right. so every year, that's also another takeaway that I think a lot of the program members get, is that, you know, it really is local.
Yeah.
And we have that influence.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, very nice. Can you talk to us a little bit about how the program's funded?
Absolutely. We're funded in a way that's a little interesting. A lot of our other counterparts really started with corporate funding.
Okay.
I think sometimes people confuse the Chamber of Commerce with the city, so they think it's a city program, or that, you know, it's just for businesses, so the businesses fund it. LMV, Leadership Mountain View, was very community grassroots. So for the longest time, outside of tuition for people to come through the program, we were getting grants from local nonprofits and other grant makers. Of course, when the economic downturn hit in 2007-08, we took a major hit because, you know, obviously the school system can't necessarily budget for this type of thing anymore. So we really looked at re-strategizing when I came on, and we created corporate sponsorship levels, because again, we have these great international companies in our backyard, and there was a gap between the community connecting with them and them connecting with the community, which is something that they really wanted to do.
Right.
So LMV helped kind of create that pathway so that they're helping fund the program by underwriting scholarships.
Okay.
For participants to come through. One in particular, Microsoft, they sponsor 2 public educators in Mountain View per year. So that way the school system can still send someone through the program without it adversely affecting their budget. Same thing with Google. They give us money to be able to give to those who wouldn't otherwise be able to afford tuition for one reason or the other.
Right.
So it's great that they do it in a way that there's no reason anyone could not go through the program.
Right. That's fantastic.
Yes.
It's always good to see that good civic responsibility from these
exactly.
companies.
Exactly. Corporate yeah. social responsibility is a big thing, as
yeah.
you know.
Yeah.
So to be able to offer a pathway for that for a lot of these companies is really great.
Fantastic. Well, I know we talked about it's the 25th anniversary.
Yes.
And I know you've been doing a lot of planning on how
oh,
to
yes.
spread the word about the organization and bring all the alumni back together. So do you have any big things that are coming up that are planned for that the community can actually come to?
Absolutely. This has been a fun, I feel like it's 2 work years in one, because I'm working on the program itself and then trying to do things to engage the alumni. I was thinking about this earlier today, and I was thinking that, you know, we're really into a new phase of Leadership Mountain View, where we do have such a robust alumni. It's really time to tap back into what they know mm-hmm. and kind of help revitalize the program that way. We had a 25th anniversary party earlier in the program year in November at the Community School of Music and Arts, and it was a great event. And then we have our second annual community breakfast sometime in May, so look out for information about that. And it's open to the public, it's free of charge, a great way for people to know more about the program and who some of the alumni are.
Right.
We've had a handful of alumni that have gone into elected office. The previous 3 women on city council here in Mountain View were our program alumni.
Huh.
A 4th one, Sally Lieber, actually went and became elected to the state assembly.
Right.
So we have a reach, and it's really interesting for people to see, you know, of all the varying areas that people are in, that the one connector was Leadership Mountain View.
That's great. All right. Well, Alicia, I want to thank you for taking the time and telling us about Leadership Mountain View educating the public about what it's all about. And hopefully more folks will get involved and your classes will begin to grow to 60.
Oh, no. Too big. But I like how you think. Thank you, Shelley.
Thank you.
Shelley Wolf is the executive director here at KMVT 15 and also on the Leadership Mountain View Advisory Council. It's a great marriage between two great organizations. How does the relationship between KMVT and LMV, how does it benefit the community?
Well, I think it benefits the community in many ways because, as you mentioned, we're all about bringing community together and blending and creating great leaders. And I think, you know, here at KMVT, we really try to build team building and leadership skills as well, just doing it in different ways. We're doing it through video. And so it's a great partnership. We love working with them. The leadership groups come in and we have the opportunity to, you know, teach them about media and how to distinguish proper content and positive messages. And again, about being a leader, that's part of being that, is sending positive messages to your staffs.
So how important is it to have your staff involved in Leadership Mountain View as well?
Very much so. You know, I got thrown into it when I first started here, which I love and am grateful for, but it was a great experience. Bobby has gone through it, and now we have Christina in it. So we're very adamant about making sure the staff goes through the program, and we find that it's a good connection because it also gets the staff an opportunity to really get to know who's out in the community as well, so I don't have to be the only person mingling with the local community. But right. we work so much with the local community that I think it's good that everybody knows who the entire staff is. So,
and have you done projects for leadership here at KMVT?
We have. So we have a program that's called Media Day. So it's an arts and media day. And through that, we'll bring leadership class in and we do a team building experience. And through that, folks will come in, we'll break them out into groups, and they'll learn how to create positive messages of PSAs. And a lot of them are about the organizations that they come from, but others are about just important topics that are important to them. We'll watch them back, we'll critique them for them. So it also gives them a chance to feel like they become better speakers and learn how to get in front of the camera and be able to deliver their messages. And then we critique commercials. And that to me is probably the funnest part because it's a real chance to really look and hear what everyone gets from a commercial. So it's a fun time. It's a great team building experience. And again, it gives our staff a chance to work with everybody that's within the organization. The idea of what leadership is all about as well, because you're working with leaders. And so they kind of get to mentor the staff while they're here at that same time. So
they're all businesses, all ages, presumably.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's a very diversified group. As you mentioned, all different types of businesses, all different levels of skill set. And, you know, some of them have been housewives that I've met that have come through the program as well. And I think it's really important because, again, it keeps them connected with the community and has a real understanding of what leadership is all about in the community, but how these organizations work. Because you may know an organization, but you don't necessarily know how they really work or what they really have to bring to the community and connect people together.
Yeah, it's the personal touch.
Exactly.
The interaction between people and sharing knowledge is very, very valuable.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So you've got a new project. Project Connect. What's that? Tell me about that.
Sure. Project Connect, I'm very excited about. It's a program that came to me in my mind about a year ago. And again, pretty much going through leadership and working within the community, I found that there is a really underserved population in this community that you know, we look at Mountain View as very affluent, and at times we forget that not everyone's connected to the internet or has a computer or even has the skills to know why a computer is important. And so we started working with the school district, and we've identified that 48% of the student population just here in Mountain View has an underserved population. And so we determined that there was this great need. So we applied for a grant through Google and got a grant to run a program called Project Connect, which basically is going to teach digital literacy skills to the students and parents, focusing on how to use a computer, why a computer is even important to have, or even a smartphone, if that's the device that they have, but really how to use that as a communication tool and make sure that their kids are safe at school,
and then be able to assist them through their lessons and that sort of thing. So we're very excited about this opportunity. So we've had new partners that are coming on board. Crittenden Middle School is the first one. We've got McAfee, who's going to be working with us, and we're working on still distinguishing who the directors of the program are going to be. But as it expands, we're going to be partnering with the library as well as the Day Worker Center as well. So we're very excited about it.
It sounds like a great project.
Yeah.
And kudos to Google for really financing this project.
Absolutely. It's a very important project, and you know, a lot of times they get a bad cred for not supporting different things in the community, and I can't thank them enough for all that they've done and really backed these types of programs and understand that there is a real need here in our community. Yeah. So they're here to help us with that, which is great.
Is it just the students that are involved, or does it touch on to the families? How does that work?
Yeah, we're actually starting primarily with families, focusing on their parents, because the kids are getting the support at the school level and getting the use of the computers at school, but a lot of their parents may not have access to computers at home or have ever touched it. I ran into quite a few parents who don't necessarily understand the real need of the computer and why it's really important in their life. So it's a matter of really working with the parents and the students together as a family and helping them to know how to, again, use basic skills, but also be able to check the safety of their kids online. We're going to bring in the police department. They're going to talk about how to use the computer for safety purposes or if they need to report an incident. So I think for us, it's a real opportunity to work with the families and help them understand that they too can get more involved in the community and they don't have to feel like they're not involved in the community.
So. And did you tell me the percentage of the Hispanic?
Yeah, well, the Hispanic and underserved population all kind of fall under the same umbrella, and so it's 48% here in the community.
Wow.
That we're looking at.
So. You would be making a huge contribution to a large population.
Yeah, well, you know, it's very important for KMVT's mission because, you know, we are an educational institution and the ultimate goal is not only to get them educated, but also turn them on to being able to feel like they have a voice. And that's really the most important because I think as technology has changed and as communities have changed, is a lot of times not everybody feels they have a voice. And our job is to be educators. And as educators, it's then to bring the community together. And this is, our best way that we can do that right now.
Mm. Well, you are educators.
Yes.
You go out into the community, all different branches of the community.
Yep.
And I think you also have a partnership with the YMCA.
Yes, we're very excited about that. That just was announced the first part of this year, and it'll be hopefully an ongoing partnership. So we're very excited. We're going to start with three new classes with them, doing studio production and how to be a YouTube star, and also photography. And it's going to start with kids working from first grade all the way up to sixth grade. And we're very excited about that because, you know, again, media is touching our lives every day, and it's really a new form of how everyone is communicating. And so we have to now start at a younger age and really get folks involved. So we're very excited to have this program with the Y. And again, it kind of flows into the Project Connect program because, again, a lot of folks that get involved with the Y sometimes come from the underserved population as well. So
will this be a summer program?
It will be a summer program. So it'll be a summer program that will extend and actually be going on concurrently with our summer youth camps that we have going on, which have always been a very big success. Again, it's really about teaching creativity and creating how to communicate through video and media. So we offer usually 14 weeks of claymation classes, and we offer usually 14 weeks of studio. But this year, we're going to be doubling the classes. So we have, again, such a need, which is really exciting for us. But it's going to be a lot of work. And we're very excited to be able to extend out our services into the community and to get the youth really involved. And, you know, it keeps them off the streets. It keeps them involved and really helps them look at further careers for themselves as well.
How do they find out about these programs?
You know, we work with the local rec departments, we work with the schools, I go and give seminars at classes and stuff like that. We promote it on our website, so you can find it on our website, and just, I think word of mouth is really spread. I mean, the great part, we just had some students that were here today, and one of the students in there has been here since he was about 8 years old. And so he comes every year and it's been great. And we actually started a middle school program about a year and a half ago, which also was funded through a Tides Foundation grant that came through Google. And it's called Mountain View Youth Productions. And through that, we started working with the middle schools doing after school sports programs. Which allowed kids to really, again, get behind the cameras, learn everything on the field. They started creating PSAs, and it originally came from the idea because it was a program I was doing with Leadership Mountain View that I went into the classroom and was working with the gentleman's class over there. Mr. Sayer has a video production class, and he said, you know, we'd like to work with the kids to create PSAs. There's some competitions coming up, and I said, I can help you develop the program, and went in there, and we did some great positive PSAs, and then it turned into the after-school program where they cover all their middle school sports. They're also the announcers for the sports. And then they do the PSAs and any other documentary type stuff that they're interested in doing. So we're very excited. We're doing a lot of great work with kids, and you know, hopefully it works that by the time they get to high school, they'll want to work on our own sports productions. We have a production truck, and we teach sports training classes through that, and field production, and they get to work and cover their own high school sports. So they may not get to be in front of the camera as the sporting person, but they actually get to be behind the camera, catching all their friends and fans behind the camera.
You're doing so much stuff with a very small staff.
Yeah, we have a small staff, but we have many, many dedicated volunteers like yourself, and we love that. That's where, again, we're like one big family here, and we love it because, you know, we all love what we do, and it's really important, the work that we do. So, you know, I'm very blessed to have the staff that I do. You know, our longest running staff member is Bobby, and, you know, he's been here for 12 years, and then we actually have Robin and Docs, who are our part-time staff, who've actually been here longer than that, and so I think that we're doing a good job because you know, we're now celebrating 25 years ourselves as a nonprofit, and they came on right in the beginning as their volunteers as well. So I think for us, we've been very dedicated, or very lucky to have a dedicated staff and crew and volunteers who've stuck with us along the way. So,
well, it's great information. You're doing great work in the community.
Thank you.
And I want to thank you for doing that. And I want to thank you for you and your staff for all of the work and the help and the support that you give the Better Part. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks for the update.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Two great organizations, both of whom are celebrating their 25 years of service to the community. I'm Val Jeffrey for the Better Part, and we thank you for watching.